On air. With presenter Ali.
In other news, I think Indo news yenye itafunga hii episode ni story yenye imekuwa ikitrend sana online na ni story ya Pididi.
Top 5 people that were allegedly bent over by the famous Didi. Right, we are all aware about the whole Didi situation. So these are not my opinions. So I'm not the one that came up with this thing. This is public information that is available on the internet. I'm just simply telling you what everybody is saying. At number 5, we have Burna Boy. Burna Boy was allegedly bent over like a little bitch by Didi. And that is how Burna Boy was able to get that his Grammy award. This is what everybody is saying. I woke up around like 4 a.m. this morning. I was scrolling on Twitter. And that is why I saw all the different reasons why people now believe that Burna Boy was bent over at least a couple times by Didi. And unlike Burna Boy, he has not said a word about this. All these things that you have been saying about him for the past 24 hours. You have not heard anything from Burna Boy, which is very unlike him. So do with that what you will. Right? At number 4, we have Justin Bieber. I don't even listen to American music, but I know Justin Bieber. He's that famous. He's very, very famous. Apparently, when he was 15 years old, Usher, the famous Usher, helped Didi to do things to Justin Bieber. This is what everybody is saying. It's on the online. You can find it. It's not me that is saying it. All right. At number 3, we have Meek Mill. I never really liked this guy. Meek Mill is a famous American rapper. He has even done a song with Davido and I think Wizkid also. So very, very famous. Everybody knows who Meek Mill is. He apparently was also bent over by Didi. Right? At number 2, we have Aaron Hall, another famous American singer and songwriter who also was, by the famous Didi. So that's interesting. So many things are happening. If you like this list, I want to that list like this. Please follow and like for more. Leave me a comment with your thoughts on this whole Didi situation. Right? At number 1, we have Stevie J, a very famous American DJ and producer who also was apparently bent over by Didi. A grown man. If you see this Stevie J, just go and check his pictures. He's a grown man. So,
so PDD right now, Kondani, alinyimwa bond. $50 million yenye alikuwa anapea na nyumba yake. I mean, that is so much money.
You know, about 650.
That's
about 6 billion Kenya shillings. 6 billion Kenya shillings. So 600.
6.5 billion.
Billion Kenya shillings.
Oh my goodness. So ideally, this is what happens. Kuna wasanii kadhaa wametajwa kwamba it's being speculated that washawai pitia kwa mikono ya Didi na waka inasemekana like these guys have faced the baby oil Didi oil. Citizen at Citizen 50 Cent alisema anataka ku launch oil yake inaitwa Didi oil
itauza mbaya hata mimi nitanunua
utanunua yani
ya kujifurahisha.
Anyway, so kuna wasanii kadhaa wametajwa hii in Africa. I think here in Africa wamekuwa wawili wenye wametajwa,
nani?
Bana and Diamond.
Oh, wamesahau Wizkid kwa nini?
Oh, Wizkid ashai hang out
mbaya sana, mbaya sana.
Wacha.
Not once. Wizkid ni amekuwa huko kwanza akiwa very young.
Oh my god.
Wizkid is one of them in yeah. One of the original ones.
Undo wa kwanza.
Yeah.
Eh. My goodness.
Wizkid, alafu.
Walisema iti, the time when Bana won the Grammys, the same time they were together. And there's a video that is trending online. Ya nani? Anitwa nani? Didi aki hug
Burna Boy passionately.
Very passionate. Mpaka anasema, in the, you know, the, kuna kitu anasema, I think the clip is you're watching right now. Asema in the, just watch it. So, do you think he faced, Burna Boy faced the oil?
Do I think?
It's your opinion.
Of course, I think he did.
For real?
Of course.
Why? What makes you say that?
Okay, do you know, number one, somebody should know. Unajua alisema something very important to kianza hii conversation ya Didi that alikuwa denied bond. Right. And people who may think that the US justice system ni kama yetu ya Kenya. So watafikiria oh anaonewa, jinie wamemnyanga, wamekataa kumpatia bond vile the way they do in Kenya. But the independence that the US whatever federal system and the justice system zinakuaga. I don't think awaizi fanya kitu kama hiyo. That's something very unlikely.
Yeah.
Iti kumkataza tu bond.
Juu kuna msi amelipa do flani. Amelipa
do flani.
Yes, yes.
Zi. Ukiona anytime in US somebody amenyimwa bond. Number one yamanishaga.
Ama cash bail.
Ama cash bail. Inamanishaga the crime yenye amako accused of are crazy charges.
And the evidence that is there against
is crazy.
Is crazy.
Yes. Yes.
So wembe ni ule ule na ulimkata bana boy.
Yes. So chances of him kukata bana boy are higher than ye kutomkata. That includes bana boy, Wizkid, this is kina Jennifer Lopez, kina nani, kina Meek Mill,
Justin Bieber.
Justin Bieber.
For real?
Yeah, kina Asha. Yeah, all these guys. Chances, you remember kina whatever kina wasn't LeBron James, all these guys, and I believe so much that this guy did it. You know why I want to believe that these things wamepitia hizi vitu? Because number one, hakuna hata moja mwenye ame come through of all these guys wamekuwa named akasema si mimi. Wakuna watu around wanasema haikuwa yeye, mfulani anasema ni nani tulikuwa na hiyo siku, but them straight hakuna hata moja ame come forward because kuna tapes. So unajua unaweza kuja useme iko wewe. It's easier to say iko wewe kama kuna tapes. But unajua there are tapes because this guy alikuwa na tape everything that ilikuwa na go on kwa nyumba yake.
What?
You get. In fact there are even situations where the other people walikuwa na molest other people. In fact he used to make other artists walale na watoi wako underage ukifikiria uko safe kuna kuwa recorded to be used against you ili to use the feds. In fact there's a conspiracy theory that goes around that the feds, the federal government, walikuwa namtumia Didi ku control the powerful in the society, the celebrities. Wakiona hizo. Yeah. So, wakiona your video nakwambia, "Eh, tunajua ulifanya fulani fulani na tuko na video zako." So they'll control you anyhow because with the influence you have, they need to control you because you're so much influential, unakuwa so powerful.
We need something against you.
Against you for us to control you. You get. So, apart from the fact that hata kuna wenye walikulwa, kuna wenye pia walikulana. Na wanaogopa, maybe wanaogopa kusema because wanajua video zao ziko. You get? A good example ni mtu kama LeBron James. LeBron James has been somebody who has been known to be fighting for the blacks.
Yes.
For the longest.
Yes.
But hakuwa anaweza ku speak all these years, amekoga best ya Didi for all these years. But Ajay came forward akasema that anything of that inafanyika. And Marquis has been fighting for the blacks. And majority of people when you did, I'm quite take advantage of. I've been the guys who are in hip hop culture, and majority of people in hip hop culture are blacks.
Yes,
you know that the hip hop culture is the most important culture for the blacks in America.
Yes,
you get.
Yes,
so chances are that people who are involved, not even chances, it's true that people who are involved.
Yes,
by kukulwa, ama bao walikula watuia, ama kukula watu wengine.
Yes,
and number two, we cannot also not shame these guys. Me personally, but the history I did, nimeona many people were make fun of them. In fact, there was this time we were sitting down with my girlfriend and she was showing me these videos. Na nacheka, we were make fun of.
Kuna video pia niliona akispunk Jay-Z. Na see once.
Yeah, sure. Hey, na Jay-Z
so akamulia. Ati akufurai.
Jay-Z alifurai.
Akumkataza.
Akumkataza. But I think maybe, but that was a short video, so maybe ilikuwa in public and tulak tuwe, kama anza kujam na because walikuwa na perform, hata ilikuwa on stage. But
lakini, ndio mimi niamue kukuspunk in public, it speaks about a lot about what we do in private.
Sure, sure.
Because mimi sahi siwezi kuspunk in public.
Yeah.
Hata wewe siwezi kubali unispunk in public.
Na nikikuspunk utajam na mimi.
Hata in public mimi nitajam.
Nini unadu?
Mimi nitasimamisha show kwanza. Niseme, whatever you've done is wrong.
Yeah. So anyway, going back to that, me, so that is a very debatable point, by the way, that these guys walikuwa wanataka hizi vitu. That's why mimi sija come forward really to shame these guys. Me, I don't stand for that.
And also,
as I was explaining for you, like my girlfriend alinionyesha some videos. Amenionyesha like anapenda hizo video, akiziona anashinda amecheka. You get? Zinambamba like crazy. Mtu akiwa anapanda stairs, eti caption eti how you walk in Didi's house. Unatembea stairs alafu na slide umeanguka. You get? Na I find them so funny, but personally I was looking at it this way. The guys wenye wamejipata kwa situation. But si kupenda
some kwao. Are victims actually.
In fact, I believe majority most of them are victims.
Yeah,
in other words, our kina bana boy, because there's a point that majority of these guys were quite intoxicated.
Yes.
In fact, there's this thing in it to psychostimulants. We're gonna pour psychostimulants. Psychostimulants make you do stuff that you're not even aware of. You get. So the guys, I think the guys were gonna kuwa.
Now, do you remember afterwards? Psychostimulants?
No, of course you'll not remember. It's like when mtu mwenye umekunywa pombe, unaoga wale watu wanakoga wanakunywa pombe alafu wanakuwa na hawakumbuki chenye walifanya. Mm. Wanafanya vitu na they don't know. Like it makes that way. So you can't remember. Maybe people, maybe if somebody reminds you. Mm. So there's a possibility that some of these guys walikuwa wanakuwa drugged. And after being drugged, wanakuwa wanafanya vitu zenye wako wanataka kufanya.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you walikataa because first ulikuwa unakuwa approached.
Mm.
Then maybe ukataa unakuwa dragged. Because for instance, mtu kama Justin Bieber, many times kuna videos...
Alikuwa underage pia.
Yes, na alikuwa natafutwa na uja maa alikuwa nakataa. And there's a video, wanakutana na Justin Bieber for the first time.
And he's very nervous.
He's very nervous. And this guy is asking him, why have I been looking for you? I've been looking for you, I'm not finding you. Then Justin Bieber, because he's like, I've just been busy, you know, you never got a time to get my number. Now you can have my number. Because I'm afraid, like, pressurized, he has to give the number. Mm. You get?
So that, according to that video, yeah. It shows that already kitu ilikuwa imehappen.
Already kitu ilikuwa. Kitu ilikuwa, ah no, hiyo ilikuwa before the 48 hours with the oh. With them. Ilikuwa sasa time anataka wakutane lakini hawataki nani ana avoid.
Kwa nini? Ama alikuwa amesikia stories.
Nikawa alikuwa ameambiwa.
Oh.
Ni kama Didi alikuwa amemwambia mbona anataka wa meet.
We?
You get. So, ama maybe too, sometimes also gut feeling. Maybe just, there's something I think almost every guy ashaikatiwa na gay.
Mm-hmm.
There's a way they come to you. Sometimes
I feel
very scary. There's something to this.
Mm.
You get. So hey. Maybe Vilalcona come through for this
it
guy.
It is very scary.
Yeah.
You may experience that. It's very traumatizing.
Yeah, very, very traumatizing.
Just kukatiwa.
Yes.
So I imagine, adi ende mahali anaku defile. That is, that's
sure.
Even crazy.
Yeah. So wow. Alikuwa convinced na vitu kama because kama Asha si alitumwa huko na company yake to go to Didi.
Mm.
Na alikuwa anamwambia the company told him go there so that he can brand you, you get. The same na Justin Bieber. Justin Bieber alikuwa under Asha. Asha akamtuma pia kwa Didi enda akutengeneza kubrand. Kubrand generally ilikuwa tu kukumpatia connections because there's nobody in music industry as connected as P. Diddy. He knows all the producers, he knows all the promoters, he can make you have a show anywhere in Dubai, he can make you produce, do a collab.
He can make you win Grammys.
He can make you win Grammys the way he did to Burna Boy, you see?
Wow.
Yeah, so... And I'm saying so, that I'm saying that about Burna Boy because why hasn't he said anything? Because Burna Boy tunajua ni mtu mouthy sana.
Nothing, he's very vocal,
He's always very vocal. But I just say anything about his stuff.
Yeah, anafaa ongee.
Yeah, and you remember also Cat Williams when he was being interviewed by whatever, by Joe Rogan. Remember him saying this thing, saying that there's a time that Didi even called him, wanted to do some things to him, and he refused. Then offered him $50 million. And he refused, you get. Then Didi now went ahead trying to destroy him. Because Didi had the power of making and destroying, you can make sure you never have any serious show.
The only time unaweza kuwa na power over Didi ni, na si power mob, juu kuna influence, ni kama tu ujiingia kwa nyumba yake.
Ni kama tu ujiingia kwa nyumba yake.
Na ukakunywa tu drinki.
Yeah, na haja kuonja.
Na ukapiga sherehe pale.
Piga sherehe.
Umeenda hapo umepiga tu sherehe, juu ulirekodiwa.
Ulirekodiwa, na inaweza kuwa ulifanya kitu. In fact, there are very many things that they used to do there. Why they walikuwa natumia...
No party, they say like, there is no party like
vile,
party.
Yeah, vile nani alisema, LeBron James. These guys walikuwa nafanya... Unajua in these parties, these private parties, alikuwa na kuinvite. Akijua wewe you have umekataa kila kitu, umekataa everything. Atakulita kwa hao. Then, in these parties, people used to cheat on their wives. You get, unapata kadem flani, mrembo mmelala naye. So, after that, you go back home as usual. Let's say when you're Obama, because hata Obama amekuwa mentioned hapo. We go back to Michelle. Then tomorrow, unataka kufanya kitu. Ama you want something from you, because you're the president of US. Na ukatae. Anakwambia like niko na video zako by the juzi ukikula fulani na Michelle will know about it.
Hey,
understand? And even the country will know about
ukigonga
it.
Ukigonga na sima yai.
Na unajua in US a president akifanya mess kama hiyo even resign immediately. Huwezi endelea kama vile tunajua Ruto alikula mama Abiy akakuwa na mtoi na baada ameendelea tu. You see, like over there like moral issues are big deal. So it's a sad situation but I'm not for the party or that are wanaingilia wase, wanaingilia kina damu. Some of these guys hawakuwa wanajua chenye wanafanya.
It's also not good to beat a man when he's down, you know.
No, it's not good.
Yeah.
Hata Didi himself right now, mimi siezi, sema imemweza. Bro, hata kama umesha imes watu waje. Hata kama ushai, me personally, me I've ever been to prison, so I know how it. Hata ushai in a prison, hata kuinterview wase.
Yeah.
You know how that place is, you get. We hata huku experience, wewe uliona, but I remember the stories ulikuwa naniambia, nilikuwa nani scare.
Yeah.
You see, but, so you can imagine, If you ever go to prison, you'll notice that akuna, there's no degree, there's no level of mistake that deserves
prison.
Akuna.
Tukimaliza hii story,
yeah.
Diamond Platnumz,
yeah.
literally alienda kwa PDD mm-hmm. na pia alipelekwa na Swizz Beatz mm-hmm. bwana Alicia Keys mm-hmm. so they had gone to US tour nini unajua ile kutafuta networks na connections mm-hmm. so Swizz Beatz akamwambia eh acha niwapeleke kwa mm-hmm. PDD
yeah.
then wakiwa pale kwa PDD and this is actually according to story ambayo ilipeanwa na manager mm-hmm. wa wow. Diamond ambaye ni Babu Tale mm-hmm. who's also ni I think ni mbunge or mm-hmm. mayor or something uko TZ
no.
but I think ni mbunge
mm-hmm.
so anasema hivi
mm-hmm.
walienda kwa PDD mm-hmm. walipofika pale wakakaribishwa akaonyesha mm-hmm. huyu ndo Diamond akamwambia muonyeshe masho yako venye unajaza akaona eh kumuza ukweli ni wewe akamwambia mm-hmm. ni mimi mm-hmm. ndo najaza hivyo
mm-hmm.
and he was very impressed
mm-hmm.
na Didi akamwambia si tuingie ni bedroom to watch movie that is very funny and mm-hmm. very off
mm-hmm. yeah.
like how do you just invite someone to a bedroom to watch movie so afterwards Swizz Beatz akakata
mm-hmm.
akamwambia no hawaingii
mm-hmm.
because we have some business
mm-hmm.
so wakaenda kwa wakaenda and then later on Didi reached out to Swizz
mm-hmm.
akamwambia you know what wale wasee wako
mm-hmm.
waambie leo kuna party wakuje kuna kutakuwa na maseleb kutakuwa
mm-hmm.
na connections
mm-hmm.
Swizz akakataa so ideally
so Swizz was protecting Diamond from that
yes
supposedly
yeah but Diamond
why would he want to do that
Diamond would... never knew
okay.
Because yeye ni mgeni wake.
Oh, okay.
Ni mgeni wake ametoka TZ mpaka US juu ya Swizz Beatz.
Mm-hmm.
Because they were I think they were going to make CD program gani,
mm-hmm.
Album gani.
Mm-hmm.
And na pia kuna some
hiyo contract ya Ciroc hiyo time.
Hizo yeah. time ya hiyo mm-hmm. ya Belea
Be
pia
ya, sure.
ya Belea actually.
Yeah,
na pia Belea, alikuwa right. na make some songs na mm-hmm. album nini yeah. na nini. Pia kuna some ngoma zimetoka juzi ameyafanya na wasee wa US. So I think it's that time.
Yeah.
So after that Diamond was asked to interview. Mlikuwa kwa Didi akasema ya tulikuwa but the things that usually happen pale we didn't record because some azikuwa for the cameras or anything.
Si vitu za kuposti.
Then now it's right now that the manager Babu Tale is saying that we tulichukuliaga Didi tulichukuliaga Swizz vibaya because alitubania sana hata time Pididi to invite kwa party yake
mm.
alitukataza tuende na akaambia dereva make sure wanaenda kwa hoteli na hawaendi kwa Pididi
mm-hmm.
so they thought anawakazia
mm-hmm.
kuna ne connection tu fulani tunafaa tupate lakini huyu jamaa anatukazia so it's actually right now that they have known that walinusurika kukatwa na wembe wa Didi
oh that's what he's saying
yes
mm. oh so you're asking me if I think that's true hiyo
yeah.
narrative yake
looking at Kenya Diamond alisema mm. vitu tulifanya hazikuwa za kamera
and
now
smile.
The manager is saying that walikatazwa kuenda kwa party
okay I think also watu wana mistake sex sides kuna I think kuna watu wana it's easier by the way
mm-hmm.
all this thing happening alafu kuna interview ya Diamond akiulizwa mm-hmm. chenye ilifanyika kwa Didi then anasema si vitu za kupost so it's very easy watu kuchukua hiyo kama ilikuwa ni kukulua. It's very because that's what people are talking about right now. You get?
Yeah.
If right now tulikuwa mimi na wewe tuna organize, tunapiga, tunapanga biashara fulani tunataka kufanya.
Yeah.
You get? Then niitwe na citizen side na ni kitu tunataka kupanga yenye bado hataki watu wajue. Something we are cooking because artists wanapendaga hiyo sana. Maybe they're working on a project. Mm-hmm. They don't want people to know. They don't want to disclose it.
Yes.
You see?
Yeah.
Then when you leave the kesho kwa interview eti what is it that you are doing with Ali the other day at his house I will be in order to tell them whatever to code na sema huko sikitu ya kupost like it's for me and you consumption it's
yes,
not
yes.
for the public's consumption
yes.
there are many things that people can do
mm-hmm.
to people that are not for public consumption it doesn't necessarily has to be mm-hmm. kukulwa nyuma
yeah.
so it's very easy by them guys kuichukua kama oh so ilikuwa ni hiyo it's a it's very possible ilikuwa hiyo na alafu number 2
mm-hmm.
the fact that wamesema I'm just trying to connect that story to this one
mm-hmm.
kama nani alikuwa anauliza nini mlifanya kwa Didi na anasema hey, vitu ambazo tuli record kuna chance that alienda na expectations fulani Diamond
mm.
akaambia wasiwatize naenda kwa Didi
mm.
so people are expecting something big
mm.
you get
mm.
then jua iku happen ikakuwa ikakuwa ni kama Didi amempiga na egg on the face
mm.
akafeel embarrassed nilikuwa nishajionyesha tutakuwa na kitu so because it looked like a failure kuja kuambia wasee that guys Sikuwa nimeenda kufanya na did mazoea ikuingiana Swiss biz ali tu alikuwa mtiaji. Mm-hmm. You get itakani kama ame lose ana manini wake ma haters wake watafurahi. You get na mafans wake watafeel disappointed. So to just make mafans wakuwe too happy and to keep the haters gazing tuambia ah mambo shuliongelea si mambo ya kuongea ili watu wajue oh so they're still cooking.
Yeah.
Rather than kuambia watu ah ilikuwa bure tu because competitors wake kina harmonize will look at it that ah alijisikia hapa na kwa did na hata na kitu.
Yes,
so
yes.
I can buy that story to some extent. But something still wait to see. At least itatoka kama video zitaanza kuleak tutaziona kama alikuwa hakuna mali pa kutorokea.
My goodness.
Na kama hakukua pia.
Sad,
but I still stand with the fact that hata kama alikuwa let nobody, I don't feel like it's fair to just rush to judging the guys when you alifanyo hizo vitu.
Because walijipeleka kufanya.
Because bro, honestly, mimi na wewe tunajua mwanaume ili akubali mtu mwingine kumfanyia kitu kama hiyo, a man who is straight. Ujama, kama ako sober for real, then ujama ako pabaya. Either umemanipulate, ama umemcoerce, ama umemthreaten, ama umemonyesha world ingine.
Ama yeye anataka tu.
Ama yeye anataka tu. But it's not something that comes easy for, my point is it doesn't
for
come.
For a straight man.
For a straight man, it's yes, not yes, easy. So yes. It's not, it can be easy to kuwajudge, but I don't think wanafaa kujaji, we should try to understand them.
Wow. Thank you. Wow, guys, funny enough, that's it for today. Kwenye episode 1 here on air with presenter Ali. If you're looking to partner with us, the number is actually on your screen. Unaweza piga simu, unaweza zungumza nasi. And also I want to remind you guys that you can get the best phones, all Apple products, straight from Inayatronics. We have them. The number to call is 0704589139. Call that number for any Apple product ambayo unaweza kuwa unahitaji. We also have iPhone 16 zimefika, we have iPhone 15, 11, 12, 13, zote, all Apple products. The number is on the screen. The episode has been proudly sponsored by Inayatronics, but if you're also looking to sponsor the episode, make sure you reach out to us, maybe on my DM @presenter_Ali pale kwenye Instagram or my email alipresenter@gmail.com. I'll see you guys in the next episode.